Today I am going to demonstrate how I collect chemical residue samples from pottery. And so to start out, you want a nice big wide flat area where you've got some elbow room and room to set out your things and work. Very important that it is not a table where people eat or have spilled coffee. It's very important that there isn't food residues on it. I usually take some wet paper towels or damp paper towels, wipe down the surface, just make sure there's no dust, everything's cleaned off. Then you want to set up a sterile workspace, and I used foil that has been ashed or sterilized so that you've got a nice clean surface, and if you spill any of your residue, it's not lost, you can still use it because it's a clean space. Start by taking a photograph of the object, and I have my broken Walmart flower pot here. With a little label, take a couple shots of it, and in particular, pay attention to get a good shot of the area that you're going to be sampling, so you have a before, and then at the end, take an after shot of what it looks like after you've sampled it, just for documentation purposes. So, once it's photographed, you can get rid of your labels and things. What I like to use for collecting the sample are these 4 mil size glass vials that have been sterilized, and so they're all clean. What you're going to be collecting the sample on can be a small piece of sterilized foil, or you can use laboratory weighing paper, which is designed for samples. So either one of those works fine. And for actually collecting the sample, you can use, I like these metal little files, diamond files, stainless steel diamond files. Depending on the hardness of your pottery, you can also use like a X-Acto knife type or scalpel blade for scraping if it's soft enough. But I like these little files, they work pretty nicely. If, when you're looking at your pot, deciding where you're going to sample from, if you notice that there's dust on it from having maybe been sitting somewhere, then take a new, unused toothbrush, maybe sterilized in boiling water, or you can rinse it off with methanol or some kind of solvent and just make sure that it's clean. And you can, if you need to, give the area you're going to be sampling a quick brush off. Right. And when deciding where to sample the pot, you want to think in terms of where you're going to get your best sample and aesthetics. You want to pick a spot where you're likely to get some good residue. So in a nice flat-bottomed pot like this, I'm going to go for the base, where anything that in the past was in it would have been sitting on the bottom or along where the junction of the base and the side wall is. And wherever is accessible as well. The size of the opening of the pot is going to determine where you can sample. So I think we'll go right here. It's near a broken part anyway, and it's easily accessible. So we're going to go here. I'm going to use weighing paper. And so just make sure you've got a good grip on the pot. Check again to see where you're going to be sampling. And then hold the pot over where you're going to be collecting your sample. Take your file and just start filing. And collect the residue on this paper. Sometimes it gets a little messy. And it takes a few minutes. Also, while you're doing this, you want to be wearing a mask. I'm not going to be wearing one for the purposes of this video so that you're able to hear me, but you want to wear like a surgical mask to do this because it's possible to contaminate samples with caffeine if you're a coffee drinker. It can be on your breath, and just simply breathing on it is enough sometimes to potentially cause contamination. And at every step, you want to try to minimize
potential contamination sources. So you also don't want to have a coffee pot in the same room. And if you were grinding your own coffee beans in the morning or standing in line at a Starbucks, make sure you're wearing a lab coat or something over your clothing, because that's another potential source of contamination. Okay. So we've got some collected here, and just for brevity's sake, I won't collect the entire sample. But when you think you've got enough, or you need to empty off the weighing paper here, give it a little pinch, it helps funnel it in. Give it a little tap and cap it right away. And if you look and you realize, no, we need a little more, just set it aside and you can collect more sample. When you think you're done and you think you've got as much as you want, then what I like to do is, again, for aesthetic purposes, neaten it up a little bit. So just try to make the edges look a little nice, smooth it a little bit, just so that the area that I've scraped is smooth. And as you can see, there's a lot of surface left for future testing, should anybody want to. We're taking just a very small area that we've sampled the surface, and you're wanting to get not just the surface, but you want to get below the surface to get the things that were absorbed down into the matrix. So you're not going for a very wide, broad, shallow. You're going for surface and a little deeper in a small area. That also minimizes the visual effect. So, tap to get it all in there. Okay. All right, so we'll say that that's enough. Then I'll take an after photo with the label back in the picture, just to document the specific area that we took the sample from. And now, once your sample is safely locked away in the vial, then make sure you label it. And I will also put it into a little sample bag. Make sure the top is on really tight. And put it in a little bag like this. And then I will also label the outside of the bag. And I do this because if in transit the cap becomes loose or comes off and some of the sample spills, you haven't lost it. It's still sealed in the bag and you can still use it. Now, this is an example here of about the amount that we're going for. About 0.2 grams is plenty. So as you can see, we're not filling the vial. It's just a very small amount. Then when you're done and your sample is sealed away and labeled, and I also have a spreadsheet that I document the sampling. Then you're done, your pot can go back. You want to throw away all the foil that you've used, set aside all your tools that you've used, re-wipe down the surface with a damp paper towel, and then start over again for your next sample. You can reuse your mask, but have a fresh set of gloves for every single item that you're sampling, and a fresh work surface. And that's it.